In this video, I am going to discuss an application of the Sharpe ratio. This application has to do with a portfolio in which we have both risk-free and risky assets. So let me go through the setup of this. We have a risk-free return, which will be 4% in this example. We have two assets. The first asset has an expected return of 5%. The second asset has an expected return of 5.5%. These returns have standard deviations because they're risky. So the standard deviation of the first asset returns is 12%, and the second is 15%. There is a correlation between these asset returns, so we put this correlation at 20%. And then we're going to construct first a portfolio of just the risky assets, and then we're going to go and construct a portfolio of which includes both risky and risk-free. So the risky portfolio has a weight of the first asset, in this case 50%, and then the weight of the second asset is 1 minus the weight of the first asset. In order to calculate the Sharpe ratio, I'm going to have to do some intermediate calculations, so I'll do them here. We need the variance the first asset returns, so that's the square of the standard deviation. The variance of the second asset is the square of the standard deviation. The covariance is the correlation times the product of the standard deviations. The variance of the risky portfolio is the weight of the first asset squared times the variance of the first asset plus the weight of the second asset squared times the variance of the second asset returns plus 2 times the first weight times the second weight times the covariance. So that's our variance. The standard deviation of the portfolio is the square root of the variance. The expected return of the portfolio is the weight of the first asset times the expected return of the first asset plus the weight of the second asset times the expected return on the second asset. And then the Sharpe ratio is the excess return, so the expected return of the risky portfolio minus the risk-free rate divided by the standard deviation. So this portfolio has a Sharpe ratio of 11.9048. Now let's make sure we've done things correctly. If we simply invest in the first asset, then our expected return should match that of the first asset, and our standard deviation of those returns should also match that of the first asset. So that makes sense. And if we invest everything in the second asset, so make the weight of the first asset 0, then the expected return of the first asset of the portfolio is equal to the expected return of the second asset, and the standard deviation also equals the standard deviation of the second asset returns. Now, we have a Sharpe ratio, in this case 10%, and our typical strategy with a portfolio is we want to maximize the Sharpe ratio. So I'm going to do data, solver, set the objective to the Sharpe ratio. I'm going to maximize it by changing the weight of the first asset, and I have this constraint in here, so let me get rid of that, and we'll solve. So our solver, in theory, we could have used calculus for this, but our solver has found that first asset weight of 48.72% yields the highest Sharpe ratio. Clearly, if we had different parameters, input parameters, we would find a different Sharpe ratio and different weights. All right, so that sets up our risky portfolio. Now I want to talk about this portfolio in which we're going to include both risk-free and risky assets. Now, we've talked about the efficient frontier before, where we're looking at a risky portfolio and we want to target some return. I'm going to start by targeting a return in our portfolio. In this case, 5%, but it could be anything. And so if I look at the math and think about the return on a portfolio, well, if I have two assets in that portfolio, then the return of the portfolio would be equal to the weight on, let's call it the risky asset. So we're going to call that return R risky. plus 1 minus this weight times the R, the risk-free return. So basically what I'm looking at in my portfolio is I'm going to invest some percentage of that portfolio in my risky portfolio and some percentage of that portfolio in my risk-free portfolio. Now, if I target a return, in this case 5%, I can find the weight required, the weight on the risky asset or the risky portfolio. So let's look at this. R equals W times the risky return minus the risk-free return, so that's this term and this term here, plus R risk-free. And now I solve, so we end up with R minus R risk-free divided by R risky minus R risk-free is the weight of the risky asset. So let's get rid of our pen. So the weight on the risky asset is equal to the return we would like, our target return, minus the risk-free rate, divided by the return on the risky portfolio minus the risk-free rate. So, and the risk-free weight should be 1 minus the risky weight. All right, let's check a couple of special cases here to make sure we have this correct. If I want the risk-free return, then I should put 100% of my money in the risk-free portfolio. If I want the 5.2564, the return on my risky portfolio, then I should put 100% of my investment in the risky portfolio. Now, just to demonstrate, we are allowed to target a higher return, let's say 8%. If I want an 8% return, then I need to put 318% of my investment in the risky portfolio. And how do I do that? I borrow money. I borrow 218% of my investment at the risk-free rate and take all of that money, invest in the risky way, risky portfolio, and that will give me an 8% expected return. Let's go back, let's say set it to 4.5%. Now we're going to first calculate the variance and the standard deviation of this portfolio. So the variance is equal to, well, let's just step back for a second on this. The whatever we've invested in the risk-free asset, we will give us no variance because it has no standard deviation. So all of the variance comes from the risky portfolio. The covariance between this risk-free asset, because it doesn't change, and the risky portfolio is also zero. So the variance of the portfolio is the risky weight squared times the variance of my risky portfolio. The standard deviation of my portfolio is the square root of the variance. And the Sharpe ratio is my expected return minus the risk-free return divided by the standard deviation of my portfolio, which turns out the Sharpe ratio is exactly the same as the Sharpe ratio of my risky portfolio. All right. Now, what we'd like to do is ask ourselves the following question. I would like my expected return to be 4.5%. What is the portfolio with the minimum variance? Right? I'd like to choose the portfolio that has the smallest variance. Well, what I'm going to do, what can I change? I can change the weight of this asset. So let's do data solver. And I'm going to set my objective this time to be the variance. And I want to minimize the variance. Of course, the only thing I can really change here is the weight of the first asset, which is cell B8. So let's do that. And what does it find? It finds that the portfolio, again, we're investing in risk-free assets and risky assets, the portfolio that earns us 4.5%, that has the minimum variance, the least amount of risk is actually the portfolio that has the highest Sharpe ratio. So if we target an expected return, 4.5%, we end up with a risky portfolio, the risky portfolio that was the same as the one we found when we maximized the Sharpe ratio. And it turns out this is always true. So it turns out that if we want to make an investment where we get an expected return and we have risk-free assets and risky assets, then we should always invest in the risky portfolio with the highest Sharpe ratio. And then we figure out our proportions by saying, what expected return do we want? And how do we achieve that expected return using the risk-free asset and this portfolio that has the highest Sharpe ratio? And again, you would expect that this portfolio with the highest Sharpe ratio has a return greater than the risk-free return because it has risk. And so therefore, we can always do this calculation. This calculation on the right always works. And so this is one of the interesting things about the Sharpe ratio. And this portfolio, the risky portfolio that we found, is actually called the tangency portfolio. But we'll talk about that later.